Well, NKU's men looking to blow their horn for the final game of the season. Home game, that is. The Norse went to work outside against Quincy. That's Colerain grad Shannon Miner filling it up from long distance. Then Paul Cluxton gets into the act. The Norse are rolling. They like the fast break, too. Miner to LaRon Moore, and wow! Northern wins it 96-84 over Quincy. Well, the high schools were hooping.
Ken Shields, NKU Norse closed out the home portion of their schedule this afternoon against Quincy, and they did it in style, dissecting the visitors 96-84. Loved those Norse, Paul. LaRon Moore, who had 23 lead all scores, passes inside to Chuck Perry for the lay-in. Then follow the trail of this rainbow from Shannon Miner. He finishes with 20 points. We also got the assist of the game to LaRon Moore on the break. All Norse all the way. They are 29-5 overall, 14-4 in the league after the 96-84 romp. 20-5 overall make that. Quincy's women fall to NKU Norse ladies, 76.
Kenny, at the highlights last Friday night at the PAC in Evansville. And the Norse, as Coach said, started this one early on as Paul Cluxton opens the game with a three-point field goal. Next, it's LaRon Moore with the tray as NKU led 6-0 with Northern up 9-0. It's Moore to Andy Listerman, who gets the layup. And right there, as NKU continued to roll, next it's Moore driving inside and getting the deuce as NKU scores the first 13 points of the game. Shannon Miner then adds a couple of threes as the Norse led it by a score of 21-4, and it looked like it was going to be an absolute blowout. Later, it's Moore with three straight field goals, the third one being this dunk as NKU took a 27-14 advantage. Reggie Talbert then gets the ball here and hits the short jumper as the Golden Black were up 29-16. Shannon Miner then connects on another trifecta to make it 34-18 as everything was going NKU's way. A minute later, it's Miner with another three as the Norse were up 37-18. Miner then feeds John Gibson, who gets a layup. NKU led this one at halftime by a score of 50-27. Andy Listerman starts the second half off by nailing a couple of threes to make it 56-27. However, Northern State answers as this Ryan Miller three begins an 11-0 run as the Wolves pulled back to within 18 at 56-38. NKU saw their lead cut to 10 with 1:48 left after this basket, but that would be as close as Northern State would get as Kevin Listerman sends the pass to Andre Dennis Rodman McClendon, who scores as he was fouled, and the Norse go on to win it 82-71. And this break, and before we go to the break, we're going to look at some pieces of that game. And NKU started out the Southern Indiana game on fire, and the man probably with the most fire in his eyes, the Norse's Kevin Listerman. We'll be right back.
Next encounter.
Well, TKR News Director Wes Wright accompanied the Norse down to Evansville for the regional and put together a nice report on the Saturday night's game between NKU and Southern Indiana for the Great Lakes Valley Great Lakes Valley Championship.
This is the skyline, such as it is, of Evansville, Indiana, NKU's home away from home for the weekend. On the river here, gambling is legal, and the stakes, we're told, can be high. Well, Saturday night, the stakes were high on land as well, as the Norse bid to upset Division II's defending national champs, the University of Southern Indiana Eagles, on their home court, no less. The payoff, a regional championship, and a trip to Division II's Elite Eight. And the Norse did take it right to the Eagles. NKU junior LaRon Moore hits a three-pointer. Next, the Norse get 3 points the old-fashioned way. Paul Cluxton scores and draws the foul. Minutes later, NKU's Kevin Listerman intercepts a USI pass and takes it all the way. NKU scores the first 8 points of the game, holding Southern Indiana scoreless for 4 minutes. The Eagles finally got their offense in gear. The downcourt pass and the dunk by Johnny Moore fires up the Evansville fans. Southern Indiana known for its tenacious full-court pressure, but NKU solves it in a big way. The runout by Shannon Miner leads to a layup. USI Scott Boyden then scores on two straight possessions, this time coming up with a loose ball and taking it all the way for the easy two. USI had pulled to within three midway through the first half when North center Reggie Talbert slams it home. Next, the Norse work the ball inside, then out to sophomore Andy Listerman for a three-pointer. Listerman, of course, not the only NKU sharpshooter. Paul Cluxton hits the three despite the foul and the fall. Next time, Cluxton tries a different technique. He lets the USI defender jump out of the way before knocking down the three. More now of that full-court pressure from USI, but NKU breaks it. Miner to Andre McClendon to put NKU up by seven. The Eagle Sean Aldridge answers with a three-pointer. That keeps the Eagles close. You've heard of sister act. Watch this brother act now. Kevin Listerman has his shot blocked by the Eagles' Stan Jouard, but Listerman steals the ball back, and then he finds his brother Andy open. That's a three-pointer. Minutes later, Kevin Listerman drives, leaves the ball off for a Reggie Talbert jam. NKU took momentum and a 12-point lead to the locker room at halftime.
The national champion of 2 years ago, the runner-up in the national championship game. We're talking about a team that's a prohibitive favorite. We're talking about the greatest hit win in the history of our university. The greatest win. Come on, back here, get it, Mike. Come on, back here.
In the second half, we installed the TKR rafter cam. Talbert blocks a shot. Moore sends it down court for Andy Listerman, who gets the handle, misses, but gets a second chance and puts it in. Next time, it's Kevin Listerman finding Cluxton alone in the low posts. The Eagles' Jason Dominick keeps USI close with the baby hook. Here's a wild sequence now. USI's Stan Jouard blocks a shot. It is saved inbounds to NKU's Paul Cluxton, to Moore, to McClendon, who hits the shot and draws the foul. Southern Indiana's Chad Gilbert drives to the lane now and gets the roll. That pulls USI to within six midway through the second half, but the Eagles would get no closer. Cluxton's three-pointer. That puts the Norse up 75-64. And down the stretch, the bench sensed it. So did the cheerleaders, and so did the fans. At game's end, it was a mob scene at center court. There was a wife and a son hugging the coach. There were fathers celebrating with sons. Cheerleaders celebrating with players. And by the way, the cheerleaders were very functional in this post-game celebration. They said, no ladder, no problem. They hoisted Kevin Listerman up so he could cut down the net. Indeed, it was a celebration to remember. But with the scoreboard in the background, Listerman urged his teammates and their fans to begin focusing on another goal.
Now, if you didn't catch Kevin, he said we have one more net to get. And love to be cutting the nets down at the Elite Eight, but just what an incredible night, Coach. I know you've had a lot of moments in your 31 years of coaching, but really, you look at Saturday night, had to have been the highlight.
Well, last year when we won the Wesleyan game here, it was a
and we'll get to that right after this, but first, let's take a look at the Evansville Courier paper, and there was the headline, sports headline on Saturday morning. And as we go to Sunday morning, there you see a dejected Stan Jouard and NKU celebrating in the background as they win the Great Lakes Regional. some of the celebration Saturday night in Evansville, Indiana. And Coach, you probably just can't look at that enough. It was just one of those magical moments you'll always remember.
Very special. Those are very, very wonderful moments when something like this happens, and it really just brings a lot of great.
That's all the time we have for now. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Welcome to Sports View. I'm Don Weber. The NKU Norris men's basketball team is still on cloud nine after winning the Great Lakes Regional on Saturday over defending national champion Southern Indiana. Here's a look back. The Norse took the court knowing that they would have to play a near-perfect game to pull off the upset of the defending national champions. And NKU came out on fire as LaRon Moore buries the three-point field goal. Next, it's Paul Cluxton scoring as he was fouled. Minutes later, it's NKU's Kevin Listerman coming up with the interception. He goes all the way for the layup and two as the Norse led 8-0. USI finally gets it going as Johnny Moore receives the down-court pass and goes in for the jam. Here's Northern beating the Screaming Eagles full court press as Kevin Listerman sends a long pass to Shannon Miner, who goes in for the easy layup. USI pulled to within three in the first half before Reggie Talbert gets the dunk. Next, it's Andy Listerman with the tray. A minute later, Cluxton dials long distance once again as the Norse had a sizable lead. Kevin Listerman then drives and leaves the ball off to Talbert, who slams it home as NKU led at the half 48-36. In the second half, it's Talbert with the block. Moore sends the ball down to Andy Listerman, who misses the layup, but he gets the rebound and scores on the second chance. Next, it's Kevin Listerman finding Paul Cluxton all alone underneath for the deuce. Watch this sequence as Stan Gerard blocks Andy Listerman's shot. The ball is saved inbounds to Cluxton, who passes to Moore, who then finds Andre McClendon, who scores as he was fouled. Later, it's Cluxton with another tray as NKU led 75-64. The Norse maintained control the rest of the way and went on to win the Great Lakes Regional 99-87 and earn their first ever trip to the Elite Eight. After the game, it was pure ecstasy for the Norse coaches, players, and fans. Earlier today, NKU head coach Ken Shields reflected back on the big victory.
Everybody came together, as you can see at the end. Everybody was one, and to bring that particular title back to NKU is something very special.
You can hear more from the coach on the Norse Report tonight, tomorrow at 8:30 on TKR6. NKU will meet Cal Bakersfield on Wednesday, March 20th in the first round of the Elite Eight in Louisville. We'll have more after this.
See if it's going anywhere after this one. NCAA Division II tonight, NKU was a winner. We're at Connor High School.
...6-70. Congratulations to Northern Kentucky's basketball team. Tonight they knocked off Southern Indiana 99-87 to advance to the NCAA Divisions II Elite Eight. Division II Elite Eight. Many...
Connecticut tonight, big upset there, and a final score, NKU. Can we see it? NKU wins. They beat Southern Indiana. You don't see it. There it is, 99-87. Thank you. And they are in the Elite Eight of Division II. On the high school...
...one. And in college basketball's Division II tournament, NKU wins big, over Southern Indiana. It's also March Madness in
Andy, what do you think? Do you like the gold hoop or do you like this earring with the white design in the middle?
I like them both, Dan, but Cincinnati's not ready for that. An anchor and earrings?
I'm not talking about myself. I'm talking about NKU coach Ken Shields. We'll have the story coming up in sports.
Advised by ESPN. The Division II tournament has already been whittled down to the Elite Eight, and Northern Kentucky is still alive. NKU is three steps from a national championship. The quarterfinals will be held in Louisville a week from Wednesday, and the Norse faces Cal State Bakersfield, a team it lost to by 12 points in December. Last year, NKU was just happy to make the tourney. In fact, head coach Ken Shields made good on a promise to have his head shaved if the Norse got in.
This year, I promised them that if we got to the Elite Eight, knowing that we would have to go through Southern Indiana to do it, and the arduous task that that would be, that I would allow them to put a hole in my ear and put an earring in there that I would wear for a week. At 54 years old, I'm going to look kind of funny, but I'll feel awfully good by the fact that we're in the Final Eight.
I recommend a diamond stud, but a tastefully sized one.
And 6'10", 220. They played great pressure defense.
At Regents Hall, the Northern Kentucky Norse tuning for a spot next week in the NCAA Division II Elite Eight. The Norse head to the big show under a full head of steam, knocking off defending national champ USI to win their regional. The Elite Eight is held in Louisville, right in their own backyard. That should be a big break.
It really is a benefit for us because we feel like it's going to be a home court advantage. Our people, we're hoping, will come down and support us down there in Louisville.
The Golden Eagles.
That's what I want from him, and I think he understands that.
Meanwhile, another Kentucky team is gearing up for the tournament. NKU has made the Elite Eight in Division II. Tickets for NKU's next game go on sale tomorrow. The next game is March 20th in Louisville. For more info, call 572-6639, 572-6639. There is an opening for a head coach in UC's conference. Northern Kentucky had a big pep rally for the Norse. They've made it all the way to the Elite Eight of Division II. Coach Ken Shields was the center of attention. He made good on a promise to pierce his ear.
We appreciate all your support and enthusiasm, and give me a few prayers during this endeavor.
That Coach Shields sat down to get ready for the big moment. Last year, Shields shaved his head. This year, the earring, and just like that, he has a diamond stud in his ear. The Norse play Cal State Bakersfield Wednesday night in Louisville. Ouch.
Game again. Basketball coach Ken Shields made good on a promise today. He told his players if they made it to the final eight of the Division II tournament, he'd pierce his ear and wear an earring for a week. Well, they made it, and he did it. Coach Shields began wearing this diamond today. Again, that was just for making the Elite Eight. What's he going to do if the Norse goes on to win the Division II National Championship?
There's been some discussion about a tattoo, but my wife's not particularly enthralled by that idea. But, right now, let's win the National Championship and see how it goes. Maybe we win it, I'll wear this thing for a while.
NKU plays in the National Quarterfinals Wednesday at 9 o'clock in Louisville. Speaking of folks with earrings, tattoos, etc., Dennis Rodman suspended 6 games and fined $20,000 for his tirade on the court Saturday night.
He's got it all. As long as the coach's wife likes the earring,
he can keep it.
Maybe she'll get it.
We'll be back to wrap things up, so don't go.
Georgia Tech at Tetter NCAA Division II Elite Eight game tomorrow night with Cal State Bakersfield. That's a 9 o'clock start down in Louisville and is a rematch of a game from December that the Norse lost 83-71. Frankly, they have come a long way since then and demonstrated just how far they've come in their big win, of course, over defending national champion Southern Indiana. They're not awestruck in the least, and their shooting led by Paul Cluxton there, the conference's three-point leader, opens up a lot of opportunities. as Ken Shields' program continues to blaze new trails for the Norse. Speaking of the pro.
His predecessor, Travis Best, had 17 points. March Madness has barely as much attention, but that doesn't mean NKU isn't thrilled to be in the Final Eight. Tomorrow night in Louisville, the Norse faces Cal State Bakersfield, a team it lost to earlier this season.
We're going to be the lowest seed at the tournament. I mean, ranked 19, we'll be the lowest seed. But when we went out to Cal State Bakersfield earlier in the year, we lost to them, but we were up one at halftime. It was at their place, and there was 3,300 people there. It was sold out. So this time, it'll kind of be like our home court at Louisville. So I think we'll have a better chance.
For us, it's a thrill. You know, it's just like going to state tournament in high school or something. That's what a lot of our players have felt before.
And good luck to the Norse tomorrow. The Reds gave Barry Lark.
Cats aren't the only team on the fast track to a championship. NKU shoving off today. They're off to Louisville to the NCAA Division II Elite Eight. First game Wednesday night. And check this out. Last year, Coach Ken Shields shaved his head before the Elite Eight. Now look what he's done. Ken Shields, a man for the 90s and beyond.
I had a promise before the year that if we got to that next level, the Elite Eight, which is comparable to the Final Four, I'd allow them to have my ear pierced and wear a ring in my ear.
And the hair hasn't grown back completely from last year either. NKU plays Cal State Bakersfield in Louisville. That's Wednesday night. Everybody loves it.
From Louisville later today on the Northern Kentucky Norse bid for a national championship. They will face Cal State Bakersfield later tonight in Louisville in the Division II Elite Eight.
Sports headlines. Northern Kentucky University takes on Cal State Bakersfield tonight in the NCAA Division II quarterfinals. Tip-off time for the Norse is 9 p.m. That happens at the Louisville Convention Center. Good luck to them.
Lots going on.
Right. Well, NKU hits the court for tournament action tonight. Next in sports, a live report from Louisville. We'll talk to the Norseman's coach about the matchup that's just hours away.
But first.
Nothing But Men, sponsored by your local Toyota dealers and by your neighborhood Kroger store.
And as Nothing But Net would lead you to believe, we are talking basketball, college.
We're talking NKU basketball.
Indeed, we are. The Norse, as they continue to roll on, and basketball fever infects the game at all levels this time of year. And top to bottom, the interest and intensity is consistent across the board. As we hear in today's edition of Nothing But Net, a sizable contingent of Tri-State fans are migrating to Louisville for the NKU Norse tournament bid in the Division II Elite Eight. Among them, Sports Director John Popovich, who joins us live from Derby Town with more. John?
Hi, DJ, and tell those fans heading down 71, the little blustery, but and it's cold down here, but the roads are fine. Come on down and cheer on the Norse this afternoon. We are a couple of blocks away from the convention center where the Division II Elite Eight is being held. With us is the head coach of the Norse, Kenny Shields, and you guys haven't played basketball for 10 or 11 days. Just how tough it will be to just get into things again.
Well, it's not ideal to have that kind of a layoff, but the good news is that the other teams had experienced it too. But, you know, we came off a tremendous win in Southern Indiana, and we needed a few days, but we didn't need 10, but the other teams are in the same boat.
First time to hit the Elite Eight. Do you expect some nerves, some butterflies early on?
I think there's going to be some butterflies. I'm going to really try to make the players aware of, hey, if you stepped up over there in Evansville, you can step up here. But there will be some anxieties, but hopefully they'll get settled in early and we'll play a good ball game.
Do you think the first few minutes are critical to your team's success?
I think the first few minutes in any game is critical. If you get out of the gate well, it sets the tone many times for the ball game as far as the pattern is concerned. So I think it's important to get out of the gate well. But, again, they have to get out of the gate in a positive way, too. And you know, they're a very good team. But the first few minutes of any game is important.
NKU plays Cal State Bakersfield. Here's a team that owns a couple of national championships and some pretty good size, don't they?
They really do have nice size. They're a five-man. Their center, Kivu Stewart, is a first-team All-American player, and he was a great player at the Division I level, and he is a hunk to deal with. And they've got good interior size with him, excellent athletes on the perimeter. They beat us by 12 out there in December, but we were up 1.5, down 2 with 3 minutes and 56 seconds ago. We know what we have to do to win. It's a question, how much better have they gotten, and can we perform up to our maximum?
Okay, everybody's read about it, and take a look at right the side there, that little earring there. What kind of response have you gotten to that?
Well, you know, yesterday's press conference, they overlooked it totally, and I thought I was out okay. But then last night at the banquet, they chided me a little bit. But it's got a lot of publicity all over, and it's really no problem. It's really less of a problem than me having a bald head like I had last year. But we've had a good time with it, and I told them, let's win this national championship, and instead of this being in there a week, it might be in there for a long time.
Good deal. Thanks again. Good luck tonight. 9 o'clock tonight, NKU against Cal State Bakersfield. We'll be back with a further report a half hour from now. DJ?
Thank you very much, John. And I couldn't help but notice, but Ken Shields has such delicate shell-like ears.
Yes. Then he says you have delicate shell-like ears.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. We will be rejoining you at 6:20. UC's just sent us a fax. They have a limited number of tickets for the...
Today, right.
Keep us guessing.
Thanks. After a two-day rest, March Madness heating up again.
And tonight, a Tri-State team tips off in the Great Eight. Up next, we'll take a look at the NKU Norsemen in the Division II quarterfinals. First, though, here's a look at Wall Street.
The Dow Jones Industrial...
Virginia. In college hoops, Northern Kentucky plays in the Division II quarterfinals tonight. The Norse meet Cal State Bakersfield. They lost to Bakersfield earlier this year, but now things have changed. NKU coach Ken Shields has an earring, and forward Andre McClendon has dyed his hair yellow like Rodman. We'll see if it works. Just a little while ago, UC loaded up the bus and headed to Lexington. Bob
unless you watch UC, and they use a little of that UC game. NKU continues to prosper tonight in the Division II Elite Eight quarterfinal. NKU going against Cal State Bakersfield. 16:06 into the game. Look out, here comes the man for NKU, Shannon Miner, with a touch. A rainbow. Fred. He'll have another. He hit his first four right there. We go. Cal State Bakersfield, though, they got the big guy, and he's coming into the house. Kibu Stewart. But NKU can play that game as well. Inside Kevin Listerman to Reggie Talbert. Big step, big business. Right now they're in the second half. It's NKU 33, Cal State Bakersfield 33. The important...
I like your face.
But we appreciate the warning.
All right. All right. Tournament action tonight takes one Tri-State team to Louisville. Coming up, the NKU Norse fight to advance the two Division II's Final Four. We'll have a live report.
And Denny's here now with yet more sports.
And Kentucky basketball, we can count on that.
Lots of basketball. You know, in fact, the Commonwealth of Kentucky has a stake in every level of March Madness. Georgetown came up short in the NAIA championship. UK and Louisville alive and well in the NCAA Sweet 16. And then there's the Northern Kentucky Norse playing in the Division II quarterfinals. Sports Director John Popovich joins us live from Louisville with more in a close game. John?
DJ, we have a great game right here with less than a minute to go. Cal State Bakersfield is up on NKU 53-52, but a lot of basketball to be played in this one. Matt Mann, let's take a look at the videotape from early on. NKU and Kenny Shields with their first appearance in the Elite Eight, and they got a great boost from Shannon Miner in the first half. He came off the bench, hit this long three, and NKU led by 10. Miner hit four straight threes in the Norse, shot ahead by 15. Just as quickly, the outside shooting went cold, and Cal State Bakersfield started to cut into the deficit. The Norse tried inside. Reggie Talbert with the jam. NKU led by four at the half. Second half, 6'8", Kibu Stewart pushed the Roadrunners in front with some strong moves inside. Then they started to trade the lead. Back and forth they went. Andy Listerman from the corner gets NKU going again. But Stewart dominating inside. The transfer for UNLV kept the Norse from moving in front. Then, with a go in the game, Listerman for NKU hits a three. NKU ties the game at 52. Now, a foul shot has just been hit by NKU. This game is now tied at 53 apiece. Let me check the scoreboard. 49.9 seconds to go. DJ, if we have some further update, we'll stay here, but let's go back to you for now. John Popovich in Louisville.
Thank you very much, John. As you mentioned, it is an all bluegrass doubleheader tomorrow. State 83-72. NKU is still alive. We do not have a final. They are down by 1 point. Ooh. Less than 20 seconds left.
Ooh. Okay. All right, DJ. We'll be right back.
Rails with the aid of huge cushions and hydraulic pumps.
And before we get out of here, a quick check of the Norse game.
NKU down by 10 seconds left.
All right, that's Channel 9 News for this Wednesday night. David Letterman with Halle Berry are next.
For all of us here at Channel 9, good night. Have a great night. Be preventing their patients from receiving the most effective medicines.
Coming up, we'll go live to Minneapolis for a preview of tomorrow's big matchup between Kentucky and Utah.
And Northern Kentucky looks to make it to the Final Four. Sports is next.
John Gibson to do anything with it out there.
Another Kentucky team trying to get to the Final Four, George.
The Tri-State is doing great in
basketball. Yeah, they are. And even in Division II, Northern Kentucky took a shot at the Final Four tonight. The Norse were in the quarterfinals of the NCAA's Division II tournament. Coach Ken Shields with the earring in his left ear. The Norse taking on Cal State Bakersfield in Louisville. Shannon Miner connects on 4 3-pointers in the first half. Northern breaks out to a 15-point lead. Here's Reggie Talbert with the slam. While the coach has an earring, Northern's Andre McClendon dyes his hair. Rodman yellow, I believe. McClendon hits the boards like Rodman and gets the tip in. But in the second half, Cal State Bakersfield has come back to take a one-point lead. It is very late in the game, just 20 seconds to go. We'll give you an update if we have it. UC.
And a good Thursday to you. Here's a sports brief. The Commonwealth of Kentucky has a stake in every level of March Madness. Georgetown came up short in the NAIA championship game. UK and Louisville alive and well in the NCAA Sweet 16. Then there's the Northern Kentucky Norse playing in the Division II quarterfinals. A close game tonight with Cal State Bakersfield. They trail by one. The missed free throw. Here it comes the other way, and the Listerman brothers hook up. Kevin draws the defense to him, dishes to brother Andy Listerman. He converts. 56-55. That would stand as the final, less than 3 seconds left, because the Hail Mary pass is unanswered, and the NKU Norse advance to, that's right, the Final Four. And Louisville follow at 10:30.
NCAA Division II, Northern Kentucky University, and go Norse.
NKU, with this victory over Cal State Bakersfield last night, Louisville moves into the Final Four and a tight finish, but a win is a win is a win. 56-55, and the Norse advance to face Virginia Union in the semis tonight.
Division II basketball Final Four. The Norse turned back Cal State Bakersfield last night in the quarterfinals in Louisville. Shannon Miner was hot from way outside. He pops the tray. He hit 4 3-pointers in the first half. NKU had a 15-point lead, but it comes down to the final seconds. Kevin Listerman to his brother Andy. The layup with 3 seconds left. NKU wins 56-55. And now the Norse will take on Virginia Union tonight at 9 o'clock. UC Bearcats have left for their sweep. University's Schmidt Memorial Fieldhouse.
Well, clerks at the NKU bookstore were busy today, ringing up items with the Norseman logo on it. Everybody's excited because last night the Listerman brothers put NKU's basketball team just 2 wins away from a Division II national championship. They're pretty happy about that. The next game is tonight, 9 o'clock in Louisville. The Kentucky
Cincinnati's 5 o'clock news for this Thursday. Carol has a preview now of the Channel 9 news at 5:30.
Thanks, Randy. And I hope you stay with us for more news. We'll be hearing from Dee Lynam reporting live from Minneapolis. She'll have a preview of the Kentucky-Utah game tonight. And speaking of basketball, did you see the game-winning shot in the NKU game? We can thank two local brothers for that. We'll hear from their proud father. An I-team investigation shakes up a local sheriff's department. All right, thanks, Denny.
Well, as the Wildcats and Bearcats claw their way to the Final Four, one local team is already there, the Northern Kentucky Norse.
That's right. As Denny just mentioned, the Norse play in the Division II semifinals tonight in Louisville. And the unexpected heroes of last night's game were two brothers who teamed up to get them there. Now, with the campus abuzz about the big win, their proud father is riding the wave of excitement as well.
Everybody's really pumped up. They're excited. This is the first time going to a Final Four.
Mayor Pond, we're going to the game tonight. We're ready.
People are really buzzing about the game. That's all people are talking about.
To get to this point, the Norse got some unexpected heroics from two brothers, Andy and Kevin Listerman. The two grew up in Northern Kentucky. Their dad, Mike, coached both of them at Covecath High School. During last night's game, Mike just felt something big was going to happen.
Then we went down the stretch. I turned to my wife and I said, you know, somebody's got to step up for us. And I also added, I said, I think it's going to have to be one of our two.
And they both did step up, big time. Kevin made a great pass to Andy for the game-winning basket with just 2.8 seconds left. Coach Dad was on the edge of his seat every tick of the clock.
As we come up the floor, the clock is ticking down. I'm just thinking, go to the hole. Just go to the hole. So I saw Kevin put it to the floor and head to cut to the top of the key. And he was right on. I saw blue shirts coming at Kevin, and I thought, oh, my God. You know, I saw the pass. And to be honest with you, I didn't know it was Andy on the other side from where we were sitting. We were blocked out. And all of a sudden, I saw Andy go up in the air with the ball. And, you know, it was a no-doubter. It was going home.
So the Norse roll on. Tonight it's the Final Four in Louisville, and win or lose, Coach Dad will only have one thing to say after the game.
I love them. That's all. They know that.
What a great game. Dozens of fans will load up a couple of buses tonight and drive to Louisville for the game. They'll leave at 6:30 from Regents Hall. Tip-off is at 9 o'clock.
Proud Papa there. Non-basketball news now about...
...half hour from now. But just down the road in Louisville, another local team is preparing for a Final Four appearance tonight. The NKU Norse won in dramatic fashion last night because of brothers Kevin Listerman and Andy Listerman.
Work at the perimeter. You don't expect John.
This was a strange game for NKU. In the first half, Shannon Miner came off the bench and nailed four straight three-pointers. At one stage, the Norse led by 15 points.
Once I start hitting my first two shots, I feel real confident. You know, sometimes I'll get down after I miss the first two, but then the chances of me hitting the next one are good, so I keep shooting.
But the shooting of Miner and his teammates went into a deep freeze, and Cal State Bakersfield took the lead over the staggering Norse.
Like a prize fighter, staying on their feet when your jaw's been jacked, and somehow we found a way.
They found a way in the final 2 minutes. Andy Listerman hit a three to tie the game at 52. On foul shooting, Cal took a one-point lead in the final half minute. Then, 13 seconds to go, Reggie Talbert bricked a couple of foul shots for the Norse, and with 11 seconds to go, Tracy Aqua missed two for the Roadrunners. This was the last chance.
I told them that we had to, if they made or missed it, we had to get it and push it hard. At that point in time, we had to take it to the bucket, and I said we wouldn't need a three.
Freshman Kevin Listerman grabbed the rebound and hurried the ball up court. Time ticked under 10 seconds. He drove into the lane, spun around, and hit his older brother Andy, who was darting in from the right side.
I had to confess, I was going to shoot it until the last second, and I saw Andy made a heck of a cut and found himself wide open at the blocks.
It was a well-orchestrated play that looked like the brothers Listerman had practiced all their life in the backyard.
Not really, no. It's just, in fact, our parents won't even let us play one-on-one anymore. It gets too competitive.
The Roadrunners had one last chance to get the ball in play, but the pass was intercepted. NKU was a winner and in the Final Four, thanks to the last-minute heroics of the Listermen.
What did you say to Kevin after the game?
I just told him I was so proud I was his brother.
And Kevin was glad that he was Andy's brother. I'll tell you, that was as exciting a finish as you'll find, whether it's Division I, Division II, or Division VIII. Great basketball game. NK against Virginia Union in the semifinals in Louisville tonight. For now, John Popovich live in Lexington. We'll be back a half hour from now with more UC Bearcats in practice today. DJ?
John, the good news is Carol has used her extensive network of contacts. She has a prime table for you and Sean Dunster at Bravo Patino up the street there.
I think that's just perfect. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, John. Enjoy. Bon appetit. Thank you, Carol.
Me and Rick, we're just like...
Bearcats and the Yellow Jackets wait around for tomorrow night's game. The NKU Norse are chomping at the bit. In Louisville, they play again tonight. It's NKU against Virginia Union. That's in the NCAA Division II semifinals. NKU got to the Final Four when they scored in the closing seconds to eliminate Cal State Bakersfield in the quarterfinals last night.
We beat Southern Indiana last year's national tournament to get here. Tonight we beat the national champion of 2 years ago, Cal Bakersfield. If we beat Virginia Union tomorrow night, we will have beaten the last three national championships in succession.
Best of luck to Kenny Shield and his Norsemen. And again, they play tonight. If they win, they play in the championship game Saturday afternoon. John Popovich in Lexington, back to you, DJ.
Thank you very much, John.
Annapolis with the Kentucky Wildcats. We'll go to Lexington and UC in just a minute, but first, how about the Norse? Northern Kentucky has made it to the Final Four in Division II. That means two more wins, and they take the whole deal. Tonight, Northern goes against Virginia Union. Virginia Union is a two-time national champ. They'll tip it off at 9 down in Louisville. We'll have the highlights at 11. Last night, the Norse pulled it out against Cal State Bakersfield. NKU down one. Freshman Kevin Listerman takes the rebound. The length of the floor at the last second. He finds his brother Andy. Andy lays it in for the game winner. NKU wins at 56-55. That's how the Norse advance to the Final Four in high school.
The Northern Kentucky Norse are shooting for their first Division II title, and the UC Bearcats are preparing for Georgia Tech. Our John Popovich is in Lexington to take a look at both games for us. John?
Hi, Randy. Hi, Jeanette. I'll tell you what, it is a special time in Kentucky these days for a number of reasons. After all, most of these people enjoyed last night Kentucky getting in to the Elite Eight. UC tries to get there tonight, and NKU is in the national championship game. The Division II semifinals in Louisville last night, a lot of NKU fans came down the interstate. And they watched Paul Cluxton get back his shooting touch. In the first half, he nails a three from the wing. But he wasn't the only threat. Andy Listerman, the hero the night before, he sinks a three from the other side. Northern with the upper hand against Fort Hays State. The Norse led by 12, or against Virginia Union. Listerman to Shannon Miner, back to LaRon Moore for the stuff. But Virginia Union managed to come back in this game. This four-point play, a three-pointer and a foul, helped the comeback mightily. They tied it at 66. Setting up the climax, LaRon Moore spinning and shooting from the baseline. NKU goes to the national championship game with a 66-66 victory.
Obviously, it wasn't going to be much time for them to do something. We would have had a chance to stick it back in, but he had a good look at the basket, and LaRon, just you could see he had his balance and had a great chance of going, and when it went swish, I was on my knees.
Kenny will be on his knees once more tomorrow at 12:30 when NKU will play in the national title game. That will be against Fort Hays State. And you can see that game tomorrow afternoon on Channel 9. Meanwhile, tonight on Channel 9, the UC
down in Louisville, Ken Shields and the NKU Norse got a shot at the Division II national title up against Virginia Union tonight. Right now, they are late in the second half. They lead 55-49. They win here, title game Saturday. The Bengals...
we'll have a live report from Minneapolis.
plus a look at how UC is preparing for their matchup tomorrow. And Northern Kentucky is hoping to advance in the Final Four tonight. Details next in sports.
Business news that affects you.
And we'll show you Kentucky highlights as well as NKU highlights as the Norse roll to a national title.
Well, it was also a good night for Northern Kentucky University. They will play tomorrow in the Division II national title. NKU ran a close one past Virginia Union last night in the semifinals in Louisville. They take it 68-66. The Norse play for the national title tomorrow afternoon at 12:30 against undefeated Fort Hays. Other March Madness news.
Shot of the season. Virginia Union got one more shot at the basket, but it wasn't a good one. NKU celebrated a trip to the Division II championship game. Don't forget that game also on Channel 9 tomorrow afternoon at 12:30.
River Bucket was the game winner with just over 3 seconds to play. 20 points from Paul Cluxton, and the Listerman brothers were at it again from both sides of the court. Andy had 11. NKU now has knocked off number 6 Cal State Bakersfield, Virginia Union the number 2 team in the country, and tomorrow 12:30, NKU plays unbeaten and number 1 ranked Fort Hays State for the NCAA Division II title. LaSalle is
Union in a close one, 68-66. Now it's on to the finals in Division II.
You got a tremendous charge come Saturday afternoon because they are a very good team from Fort Hays. But, you know, we're just going to have to sit down and try to examine the scouting reports, the videotape, and come up with a game plan to give us a chance to win.
It is NKU and Fort Hays for all the marbles Saturday at 12:30 in Louisville. And, yes, Coach Shields is sporting an earring. For us, that's because the Demon Deacons topped Denny Crumney's Louisville team 60-59.
Tonight on the Channel 9 News, first ever appearance on national television. And if you don't make it to Louisville for the game, you can watch it right here on Channel 9. That's tomorrow at 12:30.
You know, there is basketball action tonight.
Northern Kentucky faces Fort Hays State for the Division II championship tomorrow, 12:30 on CBS, followed by the road to the Final Four at 3 o'clock Eastern time. Then regional final action, the Midwest final, Wake Forest, Kentucky, then the East regional championship, Georgetown and UMass.
And so Mississippi State advances in the final. Did you have them in your brackets? Join us tomorrow on CBS at 12:30 p.m. Eastern to bring you the men's Division II National Championship game, Northern Kentucky and Fort Hays State. Then at 3 o'clock, the Road to the Final Four show. Mike Krzyzewski joins us here in the studio. Then at 3:40, the Midwest Regional Final tip-off between Wake Forest and Kentucky. That's a 3:40 tip-off. Then the East Regional Final between the second seed of Georgetown and top seed of UMass as we
now they will play for all the marbles.
I try to explain to the guys in the locker room before the game that, you know, we're going for a national title. This isn't a state title. This isn't a class title. This is a
52-39 is the final.
And you know, this is something that I think, you know, Northern Kentucky really hasn't been in a position or has never accomplished. And again, our guys have taken the challenge and stepped up and performed.
Yeah, it's the first time for everything. It's the first time to go to the tournament, you know. So hopefully we pull it out.
You guys are talking to me now, so it feels pretty good. So I guess we've accomplished something.
See what a little media attention does. NKU has never won a national championship of any kind. Tomorrow just might be its first. Speaking of winning...
fans today.
Awesome.
Them coming up tonight on 12 News at 6, a pep rally for the Norse as they prepare for the Division II National Championship game. We're also going to check in live with Walt on the trail of the Kentucky Wildcats, and we're going to go back to Lexington and another live report.
Enjoying its biggest year.
They've only one game between them and a national title, and the students at Northern Kentucky University can taste it. Tomorrow afternoon in Louisville, their underdog Norsemen take on undefeated Fort Hays State in the NCAA Division II title game. While it may look like all the attention has gone to their heads, it hasn't. They are happy to be here.
We don't have very much large national recognition, and this gives us a national recognition that we wouldn't have otherwise.
Northern has become the Division II tournament sweetheart. Ranked only 16th heading into the tournament, they have parlayed last-minute heroics into wins over much higher-ranked teams. Tomorrow, they face a team that is 33-0.
NKU supporters have a lot to be excited about. This is a young school. It's never won a national championship in any sport. And tomorrow's basketball game will be Northern's first time on national TV.
The program has come a long way since Coach Mote Hill's first team in 1971, a team that didn't have a gym, had to hit the road even for home games.
We played a couple games in Pendleton County, a couple with Grant County and Newport and Holmes and out of Connor High School.
That team went 11-15. The school has never produced a player that went on to play in the NBA, and for many basketball fans, that's part of the attraction of Division II. And face it, where else do you get to see two brothers win a game with the play they practiced in the driveway as kids? It's refreshing. And while Northern may not be the biggest local school dancing the dance this March, they are still on the dance floor. And tomorrow, they have a chance to prove they are number one. In Highland Heights, Joe Webb, Channel 9 News.
And you can catch NKU's game right here on Channel 9 tomorrow, beginning at 12:30 p.m. as they take on Fort Hays State. But if you don't, you don't have to wait until tomorrow to get your basketball fix. NCAA basketball continues tonight on Channel 9, starting at about 7:30 when Georgia battles Syracuse.
Yeah. All right. Well, a hard-fought battle goes down as a loss as Northern Kentucky University loses the Division II national championship game. Now, this would have been the school's first national title in any sport, but as Deborah Haas shows us, the loss has not dampened anyone's team spirit.
Thousands of fans came to Louisville today, sure of one thing. In this Division II final, the NKU Norse would bring home the national championship.
Hey, Norsemen, you're so fine, you're so fine, you blew my mind. Hey, Norsemen!
Yeah. They're my favorite.
And at game time, the Norse came out swinging, never letting the undefeated Tigers from Fort Hays State get too far out in front. But in the end, the hometown team would bring home second place, sparking tearful hugs as well as happy for the chance ones.
It was a great year, a great experience, you know, being on national television and that. And we wish we could have got the job done, but, you know, a lot of teams would trade places with us to be in this kind of game. So at least we had the opportunity to win a national championship, even though we came up short.
Ranked 16th coming into this tournament, this was a team that knew it could win. Two buzzer-beater wins brought them to the final, but couldn't take them over the top.
Fort Hays is a great team, and we gave them a nice run, but we came up short.
It wasn't the ending these fans wanted either, but they hung around after the game to remind the players how much this season has meant and how proud they are of this team. Mike Listerman's two sons, Andy and Kevin, play for the Norse.
I'm super, super proud of not only my sons, but this whole team. They have taken the Northern Kentucky community on one heck of a ride here the last week and a half.
Coach Ken Shields echoes the pride.
This team had a tremendous chemistry. They complemented each other well. They respected each other's talents, and they were willing to help each other be better. And if it weren't for that, we wouldn't have been here.
They're sure they'll be back again, fighting for a national title. But for now, Shields has a message for his Never Say Die team.
I love you.
In Louisville, I'm Deborah Haas, Channel 9 News.
Well, it was a tough loss for NKU today, but that did not stop the proud and very dedicated Norse fans from giving a big welcome home to their athletes. Regents Hall was echoing with the sounds of applause and chants. The Northern Kentucky basketball players accepted the welcome with mixed feelings, but despite the loss, congratulatory praise well deserved, and we second that here. Now, you want to keep your set tuned right here to Channel 9 to catch all of the continuing exciting NCAA action.
And they're not going to have it, I don't think. Yeah,
thanks, Pat. And I was so proud of my alma mater today. They did so good. NKU, of course. Mm-hmm. Oh, it was
Great exposure.
Oh, I'm
national
proud of
TV
them, too.
Exposure for the school and the program. It was a great run for NKU. For UK, it was a matter of living up to expectations. For NKU, a matter of exceeding them. We'll have each team's story. Plus, the story of the LaSalle Lancers trying to become the first Cincinnati area boys team to win the state championship in 3 years. Details ahead in sports.
Last game of the year, last game of my high school career. Best game ever.
Congrats again to LaSalle. For making it to the Final Eight of the Division II tournament, NKU coach Ken Shields agreed to wear an earring. Today, Shields looked to accessorize as NKU went after rings in the national championship. Yes, the diamond stud looked great, but the ring's the thing Coach Shields really wanted. We pick it up in the second half. Andre McClendon feeding a cutting Andy Listerman for the bucket. He finished with 15. Sharik Simpson answers. FHAS up by 4. NKU wasn't hitting the threes. Kevin Listerman makes this one, but the Norse shot a season-low 29%. Fort Hays State took advantage, hitting some key free throws to beat NKU for the title 70-63.
There's 300 teams that attempt to get to where we were today. And of the 300, only two get there. There's one national champion and one runner-up. And, you know, we're very proud to be the runner-up. It was a great effort on our part, and I'm extremely proud of all our young men.
NKU finished 25-7. The season isn't over.
They weren't going to let go of it. The Lancers won their first basketball title ever with a three-point victory over Toledo St. John's. In Louisville, the ending wasn't as sweet for the Norsemen of Northern Kentucky University. Their drive to the title game had several magical moments, but there weren't any left today against Fort Hays State in the championship game. NKU's lost in the title game by 7. They still had a remarkable season. And when you say remarkable, you have to mention the Kentucky Wildcats, who blew out.
Year, last game of my high school career, best game ever.
Northern Kentucky came within a millimeter of winning a national championship today. The Norse went right to the final minute with undefeated and top-ranked Fort Hays State. In Louisville, Norris coach Kenny Shields kept the earring in for the finals. Defense dominated. Norris give it up here. Sharik Simpson on a break and the tomahawk throwdown. NKU stayed and played. Here's Shannon Miner on the 4-on-2 to Paul Cluxton for the roller, and they tied it at 41 apiece. Fort Hays had some serious shooters in this game. Anthony Pope is one of them, and that is a three ball. He should have counted 4. Norris down 5 with 2.5 left. They never recovered. Fort Hays wins at 70-63. What a run, though, for the Norris.
And earlier this evening, Coach Ken Shields stepped off the bus back on campus in Highland Heights, Kentucky. The Norris brought home the Division II runner-up trophy. They rode the wave all the way to the championship game. And inside Regents Hall, the NKU fans made sure that this team knew that their unbelievable journey was appreciated. And get this, five of their top seven return next season. Congratulations to the entire Norris basketball family. On to the big dance.
Nothing like it. In an area where Cincinnati, UK, and Xavier dominate the local college basketball scene, Northern Kentucky lives in their shadow and does nothing but succeed. Yesterday, before a national television audience, NKU came 7 points shy of claiming the National Division II title. They lost 70-63 to Fort Hays State. And the faces tell the story on both sides of the ball. While there was a sense of loss at Northern, there was also a great sense of pride. Still more ahead.
Day-long campaign swing continued in Columbus, where he acted tonight for Northern Kentucky University's basketball team.
The Norsemen fell just shy of capturing their first ever Division II national championship. They took on Fort Hays State on national TV, and they did us proud, hanging tough against the nation's top-ranked team. But despite a good game, NKU just fell short. They lost by 7 points, 70-63. Now, the UK Wildcats did manage to post a win today over the Demon Deacons of Wake Forest.
On the college scene, we have one team that played in a championship game, one team going to the Final Four, and another on the verge. We start in Louisville, where Northern Kentucky finished second best to Fort Hays State in the NCAA Division II title game this afternoon. We watched it on Channel 9. NKU in the title game after two heart-stopping victories. But today, despite this three-pointer from Paul Cluxton, the Norse started slow.
We didn't come out of the gate very like we have been the last four or five games. Everybody was a little uptight a little bit because of it's on TV, I guess.
Fort Hays State had superior size, at times threatened to break this one wide open. But every time they did, NKU would come roaring back, and they've done that all season.
We never quit. We always put our hearts out on the court, and we leave them out there every game. And it was just so happened that this game, they wanted it more, and they made the big shots at the right time.
Kenny Shields' crew rallied down the stretch, but when Anthony Pope nailed a long three-pointer with under 3 minutes to go, it stunned the Norse. Fort Hays State won it with an undefeated record. NKU's great season finishes a little short of the mission.
We're disappointed. I mean, you don't come down here to get second place. You always come to win.
It was a great ride, as they say, and we just were a little bit off enough that kept us from getting over that hump and winning.
Congratulations, though, to Kenny Shields and his team, who have taken that program to a new level. And
Calipari to be their next head coach.
It hit midnight about 2 minutes too soon. The Norse came up short in their attempt for the Division II national crown. 33-0 Fort Hays State, hoping to go 34-0 this season. Sherrick Simpson goes all the way for the dunk. Ken Shields, hoping things got better. It did. Andy Listerman for three and a one-point NKU lead later in the second half. NKU gets the steal. It's Listerman to Paul Cluxton. That hoop ties the game at 41. But down the stretch, Simpson showed why he's one of the best in Division II. Look at the one-on-one move here. NKU comes up just short, 70-63.
I really hope so. I hope it'll make us better. It'll help us for next year and on down the road. It's just, we have to remember, it's just a ball game, and we had a lot of fun down here.
Some of our players that just couldn't quite come up with their typical games, and again, in light of the magnitude of this game, we just couldn't beat a tremendous ball club unless we hit all the cylinders hitting.
NKU ends the year with a 25-7 mark. Most of the key components back next season, so they should be off to another one. The Reds lose. The
last game of my high school career.
Best game ever.
Nothing like it. In an area where Cincinnati, UK, and Xavier dominate the local college basketball scene, Northern Kentucky lives in their shadow and does nothing but succeed. Yesterday, before a national television audience, NKU came 7 points shy of claiming the national Division II title. They lost 70-63 to Fort Hays State. And the faces tell the story on both sides of the ball. While there was a sense of loss at Northern, there was also a great sense of pride. Still more ahead for you here on The Wrap when we...
How do you feel about the impact?
Our time is nearly gone, but we have a little more for you. We've just finished a weekend loaded with basketball achievements.
Wherever you turned, titles were at hand or within reach. LaSalle High School, NKU, UC, and the UK.
And if you didn't get enough, or if you would like to savor another moment or two, here's a look back.
Dave Hochter put this piece together. You enjoy it, and we'll see you next week.
Take care.
Fort Hays State, 5.6 seconds away from joining Evanston and Cal State Bakersfield as the only unbeaten national champions in Division II history.
I lost my voice this week. I was down at Louisville, and I just have to say, NKU, it's congratulations, Ken Shields, and that whole team. Those guys are superb. That was the most exciting time I've had to watch basketball games live. The campus is in a frenzy. It's a neat atmosphere to be up there right now. And another note to Andre McClendon, the man said it all. He goes, we left our hearts on that floor, and it was just superb. I mean, them guys did great. From the bottom of my heart, I wish them all the luck in the future. Thanks.
Well said.
Yeah, I actually went down to that game in Louisville against Fort Hays, Northern Kentucky and Fort Hays, and it was a very good game. Congratulations to Northern and to Kenny Shields. It's a shame that they couldn't have seized the moment and come away with the national championship, because you just don't know when you're going to find yourself in that situation again. But who would have thought that Northern would have been in a position to even win a national championship this year?
If you look at that program 5 years ago, you don't think, you know, hey, listen, Kenny had a long run there where he didn't have the best of luck, but then all of a sudden last year and this year he put together two back-to-back win seasons. Congratulations goes out to him. I think he did a heck of a job. He's going to get players now, too.
Oh, right? Yeah. And, you know, there are players in just this vicinity,
exactly.
And you guys know of them, that they can't play on the Division I level, but they can compete on the Division II level, and maybe they were going somewhere else in the past.
And Conley, the kid who gets 27 yesterday for LaSalle in the state tournament, signs with NKU.
Oh, is that right?
Signs with NKU.
Well, I'll tell you what, let's take it then. More coming up in just a minute, but we have to reserve some time today to congratulate...
What a run for NKU, but what a disappointment yesterday. The Norse had won two white knucklers, but couldn't find the magic in the title game Saturday against Fort Hays State.
Tremendous chemistry. They complemented each other well. They respected each other's talents, and they were willing to help each other be better. And if it weren't for that, we wouldn't have been here.
Hopefully it'll help our recruiting, and when people start respecting us more, like in the Tri-State, a lot of people always brush us aside since we were a Division II school. But now, you know, competing with UC and Xavier is kind of hard. And with Kentucky, so hopefully people will respect us now and recognize us because we deserve it.
A lot to get excited about at NKU, and much of that team will be coming back next season. And here's really something to get excited about. The Kentucky Post said Ken Shields is reviving a Scott Drought-like offense in order to get his team to national prominence. What's that all about, huh? he was your coach in high school, and he shook you open for some good outside shooters?
Yeah, he did, and he has a couple of shooters on this year's team who can really shoot the basketball, and he ran a lot of plays for me that enabled me to get open to shoot, and a lot of the other players on the team accepted their role in that, and I think that this year, one of the reasons why they were so successful is that shooters shot the basketball. He believes that you got to give your shooters all they can eat, mm-hmm. and if you're not necessarily a good shooter, you don't necessarily shoot the basketball. And I don't exactly know what he means by old tactics. I'm not that old, am I?
Yeah, old.
I don't know. But
it's nice to be back in the headlines.
I'm no longer a spring champ. I know that, but old.
Let's go to Jack from...
round and enjoys Kentucky in this game, and it sticks around for a good game that's going to be. We've already crowned a champion today, and we have an undefeated team. Fort Hays State beat Northern Kentucky 70-63. The Fort Hays State Tigers look to become the only third Division II team to go undefeated in the season. Sharik Simpson fills the passing lane there, and in for the jam, and Coach Ken Shields from Northern Kentucky looks on and says, Paul Cluxton kicks it to Andy Listerman, buries the three for a one-point lead, and then Fort Hays' Jeremy Keister, he's there for the put back, watch this work inside. And the Tigers win the D2 championship, Division 2, this afternoon on Indeed, 34-0, and they are national champions. Congratulations to Fort Hays State. In women's basketball, Tennessee.
As we alluded to earlier, the fact that this was an emotional weekend for a lot of local
sure
basketball
was.
Fans.
Disappointing for UC and NKU.
And I'm sure there's going to be a run on AA batteries for all the remote controls that have been
worn.
Because if you blinked over the weekend, you missed a super shot, a highlight play, or a remarkable moment. Sports fans ran the risk of sensory overload with the overflowing schedule of events, games, and get-togethers. Sports director John Popovich serves as a ringmaster to sort it all out for those who perhaps had to leave the room momentarily.
It was the way the ball bounced over the weekend that produced a clash of emotions. Kentucky had done the expected. LaSalle had pulled off the unexpected. NKU had gone further than anyone thought. UC hadn't gone far enough. It was a run of emotions for NKU,
Listerman,
where the Norse had produced
off.
Breathtaking victories, first in the quarterfinals, and then again in the semifinals. But on Saturday, when the Norse were featured on national TV for the very first time, they didn't play their best game of basketball. They had to come up second best.
We're disappointed. I mean, you don't come down here to get second place. You always come to win.
The UC Bearcats, meanwhile, were devastating their Friday.